All right, welcome back. We are on Daybreak for the final series of the evening, and we're going to get right into these player introductions because we do have some shenanigans coming out of one of these players. So, spotting in the top right-hand corner, representing Forge Force Gaming, he is your Orange Terran player, Seon Samia!
Well, that was quite the introduction. That wasn't bad. His opponent, down the bottom of the left-hand corner of the map, the Shenanigator, is Team Outset's Hupplezug Hydro.
And nicely done from yourself to counter what I would say was a decent introduction. We did pretty okay there, I think.
Yeah. Let's just congratulate ourselves for another 5 minutes before talking about this whole casting thing, though.
Yeah, proxy hatch going down from Hydro. So what is the game plan from here?
I'm not sure, because placing the proxy hatch here is kind of weird to me. I would have thought like a more typical proxy hatch would go down on the natural to deny that, deny the CC, but obviously this is going to get units out. And actually, the creep is close enough that you can, with one queen, you can start spreading it over there. It seems to me I'm going to see it. Seems to me, still has no idea, but he knows it's something one base. I think he's actually looking around for proxy hatches.
Yeah, he's sniffing
around. Yeah. He's had a little scout with his SCV in the main, and he knows there's enough. Oh, he sees creep. He knows.
All right, so we're gonna see what the response is coming out of from Seon Samea. We do have a spine crawler already down from Hydro, and I think Hydro is going in this game thinking, you know what, I lost two pretty standard games against him. I need to change it up. We do have two Reapers, and they're gonna come over here and start going to work on these spine crawlers, and nothing else here to defend. So, you know, we do have two links coming out, but two Reapers can do away with two links fairly quickly. It just takes three shots collectively. And so here we go. The Reapers are going to start to get to work on the Spinecrawler, but the Spinecrawler is going to pop before at least they get one of them. And it's going to get, ooh, it should have targeted one of them. It almost was able to get one. But now if you look back at the response, he's still building his CC. He's just going to go right into Hellions, it looks like, and he's going to produce a Bunker. Actually, he's going to produce two Marines out of that, so probably a good decision to have earlier units as opposed to getting those Hellions out. It is going to be a tech lab, so siege tank is the choice response, and I like that a lot. You know, Hydra's going to have to make this work, essentially. You know, if he loses the proxy hatch and doesn't kill Seon Samea, you know, going back home and restarting and picking up from this where he left off is going to be rather difficult. Oh. Speed does finish. We have a lot of Lings here, but they already have the bunker ready to repel them.
Yeah, and across the map, the Reapers have made their way back into Hydra's base. There's one queen there, but with the Reapers micro-ing back and forth, they should be able to deal with that and then start focusing down some drones. In fact, they're just going to target fire drones. Ooh, nice micro. One of those Reapers gets out with two health. And there's an engineering bay block denying a... one of the Reapers goes down. Engineering bay block denying a natural. Hydra actually brought all his Lings back across the map. So, Seon Samea doesn't really have enough to push out and get the Spinecrawler, but he does have that tank up now, and with the tank, he can start moving it forwards and pushing back these Spinecrawlers, because tanks outrange everything. And the thing about doing this to Terran, he's denied the natural really well, but Seon Samea has just built his natural in his main base, and he can fly that out when he feels ready, and wow, I think that's a little bit daring.
He's going to do it. He's going to do it so he can limit the creep spread, of course, before it's able to start going. And now just the creep trimmer's going down, but he's going to go ahead and put down his command center. And you know, I actually like the decision out of him because he's going to limit what is the killer in this instance is the creep spread and not being able to restart. Seon Samea with a massive supply lead, and he already has siege tanks up in pretty decent positions. Four Marines down here, and you can bring him back in micro because that siege tank is going to be able to take care of those Lings and make pretty short work out of him. Of course, four more Marines on the field. Going to do away with that Overlord, and actually a pretty decent supply block now. Seon Samea looking to be in a really good position. I don't think Hydro really, really knew what he was doing with this. I'm going to go ahead and say I think there was a little bit of maybe, you know, caught between a world of, yeah, I've got a cheese ready, but where do I go from here? I don't know.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like abilities really practiced too much. Now, Seon Samea has had a really great logical response to it, getting siege tanks out really quickly, and he's killed one of the spine crawlers. The other one's going to go down very, very soon. The creep, which is the big advantage of this, to block the orbital command. The orbital command already landed. Seon Samea managed to move it out really, really early, actually.
Yeah, good idea, too.
And yeah, absolutely fantastic timing. I thought it was a little early, but obviously I was completely wrong. Yeah, now there's... Hydro out of this has gotten I don't know, like, he's forced two tanks out of Sensenmeyer, which is going to make him really, really strong against any follow-up pushes. And Sensenmeyer is on 40 SCVs to 17.
Yeah.
Hydro has to make something big happen. Yeah. I don't think there's any way he can come back into this by droning.
And another thing I wish Hydro would have done is I wish he would have left that queen producing creep tumors through various parts of the creep now, because he would be able to spread that creep to any third expansion of Sansamia. And, you know, cleaning up creep takes some time, so anything that would have limited Sansamia's ability to continue macroing and get as macro as he can. The benefit from the creep now is that he does have to use scans, of course, to get rid of that, which he is doing. And he's going to go ahead and clean up the rest of these creep tumors. But the vision would have been nice. And of course, he would have been able to deny thirds if he had committed to creep spread.
Yeah.
Now there's a bunch of larvae left over from that proxy hatch.
Might as well.
Yeah, okay. So Nidus Worm, what do you think about this? I mean, he does have an overlord getting angling into position there at the top of the base, but is it going to be, you know, he's just not even going to have enough units. Like, those lings are going to die to the amount of siege tanks that he has.
Yeah, well, I think Sansamaya has vision over every corner of his base, and that's basically what I think about this Nidus Worm
play. Yeah.
So Hydro is going to move in. I don't think Hydro's even going to move his overlord in far enough to see the barracks and factory. He's just going to move it in just enough to... Okay, maybe he is. He's going to sort of try and find a good location for it. No. If he just plonks down a Nidus Worm, Sansmare should spot it immediately.
Ooh, but he's boosting out with this medevac while he tries to take a third. So, you know, he has loaded up that Nidus network, and there it comes. If he's going to hear it and pull SCVs and try and deny it, let's see the response.
There we go. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So he's going to be able to stop this because Nidus Worms die rather quickly, and he's going to be able to able to finish it. So now he knows what he's up against. Hydro tried two really cheeky things to try and take game one by surprise, but Sansmeyer was really able to deny both of them. Of course, proxy hatch and a Nidus Worm play. So now this dual medevac drop coming into the main, and it's probably looking to get a lot of work done because, you know, you've got medevacs supporting bio and individual lings streaming him don't do too well against that, it turns out. And GG is called. Yeah.
Welcome back to Overgrowth for what could be our final match of the night, and wanting to make sure that it is. Up in the top right-hand corner, we have an orange turn from Four Forge Gaming. We have Sansamaya.
Damn, that was quality. And his opponent in the bottom left corner fighting for his tournament life and the chance to progress on to the round of 16 on Overgrowth. He is currently down 1-0. Your purple Zerg player representing Outset Gaming, Hydro!
Oh, yes. No craziness coming out of him this game. Just very, very standard. 15 hatch, 16 pull, double queens. He's getting that link speed nice and fast, so he'll have the option of clearing out the Reapers and taking map control once that finishes. And also, possibly chasing down the Hellions if he decides to commit a few links to that, but we'll see. We'll see how that goes on. With Sansamaya going for a 3cc build, and he is putting it in that lovely spot which Hydro can't see.
Yeah, and that is, of course, going to be part of his wall, and it's something we've seen actually from every Terran tonight. So both Sansamaya and Seraph are employing this build with frequency, and especially on this map. Of course, Overgrowth is a decent map for expanding on to take a third. The thirds, you know, oh, wait, he gets a Reaper surround. Oh, that's huge.
Ooh,
he's
nice.
Surrounded the Reaper in the middle, and that's such a good pickup for a Zerg player. There's, of course, another Reaper, and Sansamay is going to have to be a little bit more mindful of that. Now, going back to what I was talking about, taking a third is a little bit easier on Overgrowth compared to other maps. You can course wall off these lovely little lanes that essentially you have, or you can take the low ground if you are so committed, and that's actually can be decently safe as well because your unit rallies can be fairly close to that third. We do have a little bit of Reaper Hellion on Ling Violence going down in the middle of this here map, and so Hydro really needs to just trust in his abilities that like that he has, because he demonstrated he can play the long game against Seraph, right? And
yeah,
Saiyan Tamea, you know, might be a little bit better than Seraph. You know, that's you know, up for a massive amount of games in comparison. But of course, in the games against Hydro, Saiyan Tamea has shown that he has his number, right? So Hydro needs to just calm down. I think he's demonstrated he can play as well as anybody, and he needs to just trust in his regular standard playing abilities and go for it, which is, you know, to be fair, to give him credit, exactly what he's doing this match.
Yeah, and he is going to see that third command center and feel pretty comfortable in the third hatchery he has already taken. Saiyan Tamea has done really well, actually, in denying this creep spread by Hydro. It's nowhere near the third base yet. And is he going to get that creep tumor as well? Going to run forwards? Yeah, he sniped that
creep tumor. But the Lings are following away, and he might get a good surround of these Hellions. He's going to actually take out two already, so three more going down. Ooh, not what you want to see. So Hydro getting his way into the game, it seems.
Yeah, he's with the loss of all those Hellions, Saiyan Tamea is going to lose a lot of map control, and that's going to make it much, much harder to secure that all point. Ooh, it is Banelings. Four Banelings out of Hydro, so he's going to try and bust down these three supply depots and let his Lings in. Saiyan Tamea has a bunker, but I don't think it'll be finished by the time these Banelings bust
not
through.
Only that, you can just run right past the bunker. Oh, he does see that. He sees what's happening, right? So he knows what's happening. Forge Gaming's Saiyan Tamea has to make something happen, but Hydro's just going to go ahead and bring his stuff home, maybe to be a little defensively. Okay. And I like this decision because Hydro against Saiyan Tamea, if you remember in the first series, was a little aggressive. Tried to push a Roach Bane bust and got Banshee countered, you know, and tried to make some timings happen. And of course, the success he had in game three against Seraph was down to a huge macro victory. So now I think it's a good idea for Hydro to go back home and worry about the little things and really get, you know, culminate the little things into a victory. So I hope we see that out of Outset Gaming's Hydro.
Yeah, me too. And we're seeing 1-1 starting / finishing, depending on which one you're talking about, up for Hydro, and that is of course for ranged. So looks like we're going to be seeing some Roach Hydra play. I think if it started that plus one armor a little bit earlier, he could do quite a lot of damage with a Roach push, but the time for that has unfortunately passed. And it looks like he'll just go, you know, straight for those Hydralisks. His lair's finished now. We'll see when he decides to start that. Droning quite hard right now. It is just going to be a lot of macro for the next couple of minutes. Oh, okay, that's interesting. Baneling speed actually coming in. This is a bit unusual. Maybe just Roach.
Roach Baneling, it seems to be the call from Hydro, and interesting to see that he's going to go right into his upgrades. You know, as soon as plus one missile attacks finish, he went right into plus two. So, of course, that's a tell for us that he's, you know, in it for the long haul. Of course, the Hydralisk Den, you know, going down as well, and that'll be completed in about 15 seconds. He's got both Zelnagas. He does have a third, the third getting laid down with some creep right now to deny Saiyan Tamea taking his third. And he's going to go ahead and take a fourth of his own. Hydra is, and he's actually going to send out a little hit squad of Lings to even further substantialize that that creep spread to make sure that there's really nobody going to be able to go over there and halt it.
Yeah.
As Saiyan Tamea is going to actually load up a dropship full of Marines, and he's probably going to come down to this bottom right and see what he can get done. But good Overlord spread from Hydra, and we saw a lot of good Overlord spread from Zod, our earlier Zerg player, and he's going to see this coming as well.
Yeah, he is. There's not a huge number of Lings, though. So if these eight Marines can all get unloaded, I feel like they can take what Hydro has right now. Although a few Hydralisks coming out, and Roach Hydra, Baneling moving across the map. Baneling speed kicked in. They're going to start rolling over. All these Marines have been unloaded, though. They're going to pick off a couple of creep tumors.
Ooh, really good pickup. Oh, he didn't get fantastic. He didn't get any of them.
Yeah, no, he didn't get any. The Banelings even went off. Two Banelings for two Marines is a good trade. But if this medevac can't get out, then that is not a good trade anymore.
He needs a boost. Oh my god. Boost. Does he have any
boost? Boost is up. Does in it? Now.
There it goes. Okay, now get the last shot. Get the last shot. He gets it. Oh, man. That was close. He could have boosted it. He'd been following it, but he wasn't in a full dropship. Only two more spots left over for Marines, but it goes down. So now Hydro, I think, feels a little comfortable. And to be fair, this was the match setup that Hydro had the best showing against Saiyan Tamea in the earlier series of the night. I think it's a really good idea to go for Roach Hydro, and I think what he's saying to himself is the last series that I lost to you was pretty much only because I was getting dropped, and if you look at the pre-positioning of his units, he knows drops are probably on their way, and he's going to go ahead and be as ready as he can for that. Do you like that he's throwing down creep with his overlords just in random spots, or should he just, I don't know, use creep? Not like that. I'm saying like in his base, he's throwing down creep in random little places.
Well, I mean, yeah, why not? It gives his units that little bit of the extra mobility advantage, so they can chase down the medevacs and maybe get those last hits if they need to. And also, it's like a nice shower for the Hydalisks.
Yeah,
they're getting pooped on by the overlords. And,
here come medevac.
Is Sam paying attention? He is, and he gets on out of there. No drops for you today, Sam. But Sam does have a pretty decent upgrade. Pretty decent upgrades, actually. A little bit ahead of Hydro in some regards. And moving forwards, trying to snipe the creep, keeping it under control. Creep not as important for Roach Hydro as it is for Lingbei Muta, but still pretty nice to have, and he's going to move in on the other side.
Yeah, any time that San Samea is going to be trying to drop this, Hydro now knows that that's what he's trying to do, of course. And so as he's pressuring the fourth and pulling that army that way, he's San Samea is also dropping in the main, and he gets picked up there, loses one medevac. Hydro, yep, on top of his game this time, knows what's coming, and is actually just started missile attacks plus three. And just about to finish two, and I guarantee you he's going to finish plus two armor as well as soon as he can. So, you know, really solid play from Hydro thus far. I assume he's going to take a fifth, probably at the gold base, just as soon as he can. And you know what? Just continue to ride out that fantastic Zerg macro. We do have a push coming from San Samea. I feel like he senses he needs to do something, because if he just lets his Zerg opponent sit, he might get up that unattainable, inevitable, death ball that Zerga will be able to replenish over and over again and just keep coming down his throat. So San Samea trying to make some moves, kind of keep trying this drop play, and he's going to split up his army and go for this fourth as well. But I think Hydra's going to see it, and he's going to be perfectly, suited to take this on and to stop it, to be honest.
Yeah, I think it's, I don't know, Hydra's splitting up his army quite a lot to deal with the drop, so Sion might be able to sort of push in different places. There's quite a lot of Balings in this competition, though, and Sion's going to have difficulty dealing with that. He needs to stim and run over the... Oh, the Widow Minefield is going to kill most of the Balings.
Yeah, that is really, really nice, good Widow Mine
down
hit
the bottom of that ramp by Sion's Mayor. And most of the Widow Mines survive as well, so Sion can sort of hang around. There's still a few Balings
there.
A nice flank
sides
coming out from Hydro. But yeah, the Yanks, the Blinding Clouds go down, and Sion does have to retreat out. A lot of those units on low health, he's actually just going to trade him off, and I think that comes off really, really nicely, Hydro.
Yeah, in the meantime, San Samea is going to go ahead and drop the main. He's targeting on the hatchery. He was able to clean up actually a lot of the overlords, and so if you see Hydra's supply cap is down to 168, of course, it used to be 200, and now he's going to have to bring his army back and deal with this. This is the point in the game where San Samea is forcing Hydra to say, are you going to return? Are you going to go push? You know, what are you going to do? I'm catching you between two worlds, because now San Samea is countering, and he's pressuring the fourth, and he's going to try and snipe that fourth hatchery, and if he gets it, which is currently undefended except for a spine crawler and a queen, if he's able to target it down now, this is looking really, really rough for Hydro. Where does he go from here? Because another drop going right into the main. Ugh.
This is exactly what I've been wanting to see from San Samea all day. This is what I love, why I love watching him over his shoulder when we meet at land, just seeing him pull his opponent apart. However, four Ultralisks are coming in. He's going to get the Ultralisk Cavern.
That's huge at this point as well. Really good, taking out that tech. But meanwhile, San Samea is countering right now with that push. Or rather, Hydro is. So, you know, we'll see if he's going to be able to pressure this third. A couple of Widow Mines defending, but nothing else here to defend this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a lot back here for San Samea, though. A lot of Marauders. And Marauders are pretty good on Roach Hydro, but it's not a huge amount. However, those are some beautiful Blinding Clouds using the buildings as well to completely stop San Samea from being able to fire. And absolutely broken this third base location. But this is pretty all on by Hydro. He's not trying to defend San Samea's counter pressure at all, and the Blinding Clouds go down, but there's not many more of them.
In come the Ultralisks
from behind.
Very nice.
But Marauders just ripped through them like
Do they have
paper.
Tightness planning?
I don't think they did.
They don't.
Either way, Marauders are pretty good.
Yeah, they don't have Kindness Plating. We do have a battle going on at the natural of San Samea. Plummeting in supply, 128, split 107. The Blinding Clouds go down. Not on the Siege Tank, though. He's going to get the Yank. The Siege Tank is killed. Anyway, now these Hydras, no Roaches left to soak up damage. But, you know, they put out a lot of DPS, and there's a lot of Hydras here.
Yeah, there are absolutely tons of hiders. Sensmeier has to hold on here. He's actually going to lift up and go into the main, which I think is a good decision because he can have a nice big concave at the top of this ramp. And across the other side of the map, Sensmeier has been devastating his opponent, but Hydro is still mining off two bases, and Sensmeier is just turning up on his one base in the main, and there's no minerals left here.
Yeah, there's no minerals left. He's all mined out of his main. Hydro does have a supply deficit, but he does have two hatcheries and, of course, the minerals to take a third if he decides to. The Roach Warden going to get picked. This is good from Sansamea. He's picking out all the tech buildings. And if you look at what Hydro has in by way of tech buildings, he actually is just down to a spawning pool, and the Hydralisk Den just got taken out as well. So now he can just make lings. Like, he can't make anything else after this. He's going to have to essentially either rely on this army or remake those tech buildings, as we see another push from Sansamea as the drop gets picked up, and it's going to go right into this drone line, and it's going from, you know, bad to worse to great to terrible to all everything in between for this match. Where's this match going to go?
Yeah, this is all over the place. Sansamea has found quite a few overlords, which is pretty nice, and he's brought the boys, but I don't think he can push forward too much. There's still, like, a lot of Hydralisks for Hydro, and he's remaking his tech buildings. He's got to get a lair back up as well at some point, but also, he's hiding a hatchery up in the top
of
the
left-hand
map,
that
which
play.
Is really, really nice. Oh, this is so tough to call. I just don't know where it's going to go. Hydro has tons of gas that he can't really use, and oh my god, that extractor.
Yeah, the upgrade advantage is for Sansamea, 3-3 versus 3-2, but the blinding clouds come down a little out of the range of the siege tank, but the Hydras absolutely devour the army. Now the siege tank is in the blinding cloud, a little bit of widow mines go off, but now the Hydras are out able to put out their DPS that they are notorious for, and they just mopped up Sansamea, now taking a supply deficit. Hydro, let's see if he can push the advantage. There are no other units. These medevacs are going to go down like flies. They're gone. Look, there's 28 SCVs, 2 mines, and 3 medevacs. This is going to be GG, and Hydro's going to be able to tie it up the first game. He's going to be able to take off Forge Force Gaming's Sansamea. He's going to force a game 3 tonight.
I think you're right. Sansamea could cling on at this planetary fortress, maybe, but it's going to be tough. Just a blinding cloud on the planetary fortress would kill it, and Sansamea's trying to hold on this ramp. I don't think Hydro's going to be able to break him just yet, but it's looking to be only a matter of time. Sansamea really, really has to pull something crazy to get back into this.
Yeah, Hydra's reestablished his main hatchery, so he's going to get that production in way. And of course, if we look at the structures again, we do have another Roach Warren going down, of course, that's already finished, and of course, Lair Tech. So the Blinding Cloud does go in the Planetary Fortress. The SCVs are repairing, but there's a lot of damage coming out from these Hydras, and they're going to... Oh, it's so close, but the Vial looks like it's going to force back those Hydras from the brink of death. And now, Sansamea has taken a supply lead with a Thor and a Bio Force that is coming across the map, and Hydro types in. Oh my god, he didn't expect it. That was so close, and it was almost the game. He threw away that Hydra Force, and he lost it. Sansamea taking game 2.